But if you got respect for a man, then you gonna give him that respect.
So Ben Turpin should be looked upon as a hero? A neighborhood hero?
I would say yes. Very much so.
He was a buffer between white police officers and the black community.
He was between the blacks and the prejudiced whites that used to be on the police force.
Now let me ask you this, Levi. What year was that when this black police officer pulled a gun over here on the Jefferson? That police station over there on Jefferson. When the white police officer beating the blacks up over there and some black police officers confronted the white police officers. You remember when that happened? It was after 67.
Yeah,
it was over there. It was
after 67.
What was that riot? I mean, what was that station?
68 sometime.
And when the white police officers, they were dogging some blacks over there, and the black police officers pulled their guns on the white police officers there in the station and made them stop abusing them blacks at that time. That was the era when, at 67, after the riot, more blacks started going on police force. Levi went in 66. After 67, Charlie North down on 12th Street.
I worked with Charlie when they bring the rats came out.
So that was the way, at that point we had black police officers, and my attitude, a lot of attitude was, we knew we needed to have our community police, unlike now, these guys, the young cats now don't respect police. They're very, very disrespectful.
And the thing was, all we did was
maintain order.
People buffers between what was happening with the blacks
and the white community.
You know, because we wasn't gonna let them just run over. You know, hey, wait, that ain't right, so and so. You just can't do what you want to do. And that's what the whites wanted to do. They wanted to just, hey, grab you and do what they wanted to do. No, we wasn't gonna let that happen. No, that's what I'm saying. Jump on you, do whatever. We wasn't gonna let that happen. So that was the difference.
The Crime Control and Safe Streets Act. So the federal government started allocating money to a lot of local police departments. They were getting all of these federal dollars to create these little Gestapo units. Why did they do this in June 1968? This is because in April of 1968, the black community, the foundation of black community in America, shut this damn country down and forced them to pass equal civil rights bills. This happened right after the death of Dr. King. When they murdered Dr. King, black people took to the streets in this country and shut things down.
Blending in with the community rather than opposing to them, imposing upon the community.
God bless our
countries.
And the thing is, those are the questions that needed to be answered then, but they weren't answered then, or was asked then. They weren't asked during that time.
They were going out here just ambushing black people, man. In Detroit, they were just ambushing black people left and right. So the black people, and what happens when they do this type of stuff, when they create these little janky-ass task force agencies, what happens is you can only suppress us for so long, we're going to react and retaliate at some point. The community is going to retaliate. It happens every time. They're going to retaliate at some point. So they kept doing these undercover hits on random black people, so black people started fighting back. So,
and going to the supermarket because they've been broken into and going to steal food.
Was this 1943 or 1967?
This is 1967. 1967. The stores had already been broken into. I live on off of Grand River at that time. There were supermarkets all up and down the street. The security guys were out on the street. They wanted to shoot at the police, and we riding at home in our cars, personal cars. But they wanted to shoot at us because they were in the stores stealing stuff. They were breaking in trying to steal food. They were breaking whiskey. They were breaking safes open on the street.
Why was the people so angry? What ignited all this?
Because they took advantage of the situation. They took advantage of the situation, and it didn't make no difference to them. They were just trying to get what they could get.
That's what I did.
They were trying to get what they could get, and it didn't make any difference. They didn't think about the situation.
They were looking to gain whatever they could.
They were looking to gain whatever they could.
They had been listening to H-Rap Brown and Stokely Carmichael.
Right. And they took advantage of the situation.
He said, burn, baby, burn.
Right. They took advantage of the situation. And a lot of them got in trouble because they were trying to take advantage of the situation.
How old were you in the 1943 riot?
Say what?
How old were you?
He was about 20.
It's a 40. 1943 riot.
I was born in 1937. Just a rumor.
So the riot in 1943 was just a rumor.
Right.
It started. That's when it started. It happened, but it triggered it. It's supposed to say blacks would attack some whites. The whites went back and said blacks attacked them, and blacks went back and said whites attacked.
Was that the incident that they supposed to threw a baby overboard at Belial or something?
That was a riot based upon race.
Situation and race. Yeah, it was hostility. I mean, blacks were relegated. You know, they didn't have, we couldn't combine. We lived in two sections.
The other, the riot
67 was about what?
About getting even, or getting what they could get, taking advantage of a situation.
So power to the people. The people was just so fed up at the time.
They were taking advantage of a situation.
Somebody came to the house.
Something happened.
Right there. Right.
And they just took advantage of it.
Was it something that the government did, or
no?
Racism.
We're talking about 67.
Because of the racist, they took advantage of it.
They had incident, they had stress.
An incident was happening, and they said, okay, we gonna get in.
When was stress? Stress was when in 60 what? When did they have stress?
What year was this? Or what time era?
Before the riot.
You say now what, Gene, they did what now with the bike?
A bicycle or something in a conspicuous area, and when the kid would come along, maybe didn't have no bike, they try to steal it. They'd shoot the kid.
Who would shoot them?
Police.
Yeah, because they were stealing bikes.
Not the black police.
No. White police.
They didn't have that many black police officers. That was the problem. Yeah. They were killing police officers. They were killing black people. That's for misdemeanor.
They were setting them up for all kinds of incidents. It was called stop robbery.
Wow. So it's really no difference than what's basically going on now with the.
It's still going on. It's not as explicit as it is now. I mean, it was then. It's not as expensive then. It wasn't expensive then as it is. I mean, it wasn't expensive. It's not expensive.
Where is the justice? Now, y'all talking about way back.
And what they were doing, they had a lot of white cops on these little task force organizations. All right? And what happened was white people were out here going undercover. They would have white people go undercover, and they would act like homeless people. They would act like just regular civilians, and then just come up with some kind of weird way to harm black people. Hem black people up. They were out here ambushing black people. The first year of stress in Detroit, they killed like 15 black people. They would just put plainclothes cops out here, and if they thought a crime was about to be committed, they'd just kill them. You would have plainclothes cops ambushing black people in Detroit under the STRESS program. Yeah? Here's some stuff you can read about STRESS. All right? The creation of STRESS. The Stop the Robberies, Enjoy Safe Streets. That's what it was called. It was a specialized tactical unit introduced by Detroit Police Department Commissioner John Nichols, approved by Roman Gribbs in 1971. It said they would deploy undercover cops for surveillance and decoy operations to deter street crime. So a crime wasn't really happening. So they would go around Detroit and nobody would commit a crime, but they would kind of create a situation where somebody would react and then they would kill them. So they were ambushing black people.